So with that being said, you an Israelite. Deuteronomy 10 and 12. I'm going to deal with you, bro. What's your name? Darian? All right, Darian. So we're going to go over some commandments because you know you an Israelite. These are things you're supposed to be doing. You come to the gas station today? All praise to the Most High. Watch this. Read what you got.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 10, verse 12. And now Israel.
And now Darian, right? Read.
What doth the Lord thy God require of thee?
Oh, God requires something of me. God requires something of you, Darian.
Bring it on.
And it ain't tap dancing. It ain't speaking in tongues. That ain't what God requires of you. You ever wonder why you probably don't even know how to do that, do you? When people be doing that, you never wonder why you didn't know how to do that?
Right.
Why God didn't teach me how to do that? You want to learn how to do it? Just start yelling some stuff. That's all you got to do, because it's fake.
Right.
It's not biblical. God actually requires something of you. What is that, Rick?
But to fear the Lord thy God.
Do what?
To fear the Lord thy God.
Be real, Darian. You ever been scared of somebody? Be real. Keep it a book. You ain't never been scared of nobody. All right. Neighborhood bully, nothing. All right, so you ever been scared of something? You scared of snakes? So are you going to go in the jungle? Are you going to go in the jungle and mess with one? Why? Because you know what it'll do to you, right? So God said you required to fear him, meaning don't do nothing that's going to provoke him.
Bring it on.
Don't do nothing that's going to make him destroy you, right? So that's how you fear God. Are you a virgin, Darian? You're not a virgin. You ever, be real, did anybody ever tell you that you're not supposed to have sex before marriage?
Yeah,
they told you that, but through your lack of fear, you continue to do that.
Bring it out.
You continue to do it because you wasn't thinking about what God is going to do to you.
Right.
Now, if God would have gave you herpes through that condom, what you was going to do? God would have gave you crabs, what you was going to do? Ooh, why me? Why me? Because you disobeyed God.
Right.
God said you're required to fear him as the Israelites. The other nations don't got to fear him. That's why they can eat frog legs in the name of Ching Ching Ming Yoing. That's why they can do that. That's why white people shoot us down in the street every day with no fear.
Right.
They're not required to fear God. We are.
Bring it out.
Right.
To walk in all his ways.
What?
To walk in all his ways.
No, the crib walk.
To walk in all his ways.
God said walk in all his ways.
Right.
How do you walk in somebody's ways? That means you're going to follow the steps and the things that they said to do.
Right.
Right? You feel like you've been following God's ways? You think so? You sure? What makes you so sure about that? You said you commit fornication. Is that God's way? You keep the Sabbath day holy? Where you congregate at on Saturdays?
In First Baptist?
Is Baptist God's way? No. Get Colossians 2 and 8 real quick.
Bring it out!
Let's see. We got, because we just read that God requires you to follow his ways.
Right.
But sometimes we forget that there's another way.
Right.
Read that.
The book of Colossians, chapter 2, verse 8. Beware lest any man spoil you through philosophy and vain deceit.
Beware lest any man spoil you, meaning make you turn bad, go against God through his philosophies and vain deceit. I guarantee you ain't no Baptist church keeping a Sabbath day.
Bring it out.
Baptists go to church on Sunday.
Right.
I was a Baptist. I understand these things. Ain't no Baptist Saturday church.
Right.
Why? Because they are following man.
Right.
You know, the Baptist was made by a white man. So was Methodist, so was Catholic, so was Jehovah's Witness, and so was Mormon. All those religions was made by a white man during slavery. So tell me, why would a slave master teach his slaves the right thing to receive salvation? Why? Why would he say, you know what, you my slave, but I'm going to show you exactly in the Bible that you're greater than me? Because according to the Bible, the slaves are the greatest people on earth. According to the Bible, the slaves are the kings of the earth, the princes of the earth. Get that Ecclesiastes 10 and 7. According to the correct teaching of the Bible, we was never made to be slaves. Matter of fact, it's the opposite. The only reason the other nations was created was to be your slave.
Right.
But guess what? You broke God's commandments. And that's why we're at the bottom of society. That's why you in Southwest with slides on, with a hoodie on. When if we was in our kingdom, you would be sitting on your throne with a crown on your head.
There you go.
But guess what? We became nothing in this world because we broke God's commandments. Read that.
The book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 10, verse 7. I have seen servants upon horses.
And the horses represents rulership. God said the servants in the spirit of King Solomon, in the spirit of Christ, in the spirit of the Father, said the servants, the people that was created to be slaves, are on horses, meaning they're in rulership.
Right. And princes walking as servants upon the earth.
Who the princes? The Israelites. Because you said you know you're an Israelite. What do Israel mean? I help you out, Darian. Prince that has power with God.
Right.
So guess what? Who are the princes that's, what did it say, the princes are where?
And princes walking as servants upon the earth.
I said the Israelites are servants on the earth.
Bring it out.
That's where we are. That's how we have landed. That's where we have landed. Just when the eagle has landed, that's when we landed in slavery.
Right.
And now, of course, not literally, when that happened, we was already in slavery. But God said the Israelites would be oppressed wherever that eagle is at. And we know that's talking about the so-called white man today. So, what we're showing you is, you got God's way, you got the way of man. Stop that Baptist church, you need to come out of that.
Right.
God never said to be a Baptist.
Right.
That's not biblical. You know what the church is according to the Bible? Is it St. Mark Baptist Church? St. Luke. No, St. John. St. Matthew.
Bring it out.
Surely the church is one of the gospels. Read what you got.
The book of Acts, chapter 7, verse 48. Howbeit the Most High dwelleth not in temples made with hands.
Wait, so God don't dwell in that church? God ain't there? Where is God? Who is God dealing with? Acts 20, is it? Yeah.
37. Verse 37. This is that Moses which said unto the children of Israel, a prophet shall the Lord your God raise up unto you.
He said unto the children of Israel.
Right.
So that's the topic at hand, the children of Israel. Right.
And your brethren, like unto me, him shall ye hear. This is he that was in the church.
Wait, now it's saying it's the church. Now it's saying it's the church. So who is the church? The Israelites.
That's right.
The Israelites is the church. So guess what? Who are we? Who we be? We be the Israelites.
That's right.
So guess what that means? God is amongst us. But guess what? God is not amongst us when we do what? Judah 5. So God is amongst the Israelites when they're keeping his commandments. But you agreed that we left those commandments, right? Read that.
The book of Judah, chapter 5, verse 20. Now therefore, my Lord and Governor, if there be any error in this people, and they sin against their God.
But this people, the Bible is only about one nation of people.
Bring it out.
It speaks of the other nations,
right.
But it's our book. It's about us, the blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans.
Right.
If I ask you, say if this not about us, where is our history? Tell me, where can we find our history before 1619? Is it on the hieroglyphics? Is it in the Book of the Dead, the papyrus? It's in the Holy Bible. All right? Read.
And they sin against their God. Let us consider that this shall be their ruin. And let us go up, and we shall overcome them. But if there be no iniquity in their nation, let my Lord not pass by. Lest their Lord defend them, and their God be for them.
So God was dealing with us. But when we broke his commandments, he stopped dealing with us, right?
Right.
So go back to Deuteronomy 10 and 12.
Yes, sir.
So we can finish that out. And then I'm going to show you exactly what you have to do, starting now, to help God start back dealing with us as a nation.
Right.
You want God to you want us to stop getting shot down in the street, right? You want us to stop filling up the prison houses, right? Stop filling up Section 8. Stop filling up the unemployment office, right? This is what we got to do. Read.
Deuteronomy chapter 10, verse 12. And now Israel, what doth the Lord thy God require of thee? But to fear the Lord thy God, to walk in all his ways, and to love him, and to serve the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul. To keep the commandments.
What do we have to do?
To keep the commandments.
You heard that, D? God said we got to keep the commandments.
Right.
That's what's required of you. If something is required of you, is it even an option? Is it optional? No, you don't have a choice. Either you repent and keep God's commandments or die.
Right.
That's it. That's your only option. And guess what? God is recording this day. Get that, Deuteronomy 19. Or Deuteronomy chapter 5, 30 and 5.
19.
Yeah, get that. Get that.
The book of Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 19. I call heaven and earth to record this day against you that I have set before you life and death.
What?
I set before you life and death.
That's what we said before you, life and death. What you think is death? Exactly. Exactly. So what's life? Plain and simple, right? God said, I said before you life and death. Read.
And blessing and cursing.
You like being cursed? You like being at the bottom of society? So what you got to do? Exactly.
Right.
Come on.
Therefore, choose life.
Do what?
Choose life.
God making it easy for you. What if your teacher gave you a test and gave you the answers?
Bring it out.
Are you going to still get the questions wrong?
Bring it out. Bring it out.
She gave you the answers. Right. You're going, oh, well, you give me the answer, I'm obviously going to choose that. Right? God said choose life or death. Why is it that we say death for 500? Give me death for 500.
Right.
Now you just lost for no reason. God is showing you the way wherein you must walk.
Right.
You understand? That's it. This is your opportunity. Come on.
That thou and thy seed may live.
That you may what?
That thou and thy seed may live.
So you'd rather live than die, right? Matthew 19:16. I gotta beat this on the head. Because you at that Baptist church, they told you you don't gotta keep the commandments.
Bring it out.
Whether you believe it or not. Oh, well, they sold me the tithes. We ain't talking about that. You ain't even supposed to be doing that. You understand? Read.
The book of Matthew, chapter 19, verse 16. And behold, one came and said unto him, good master, what good thing shall I do that I may have eternal life?
What good thing do I need to do so that I can live? You want eternal life? Read.
And he said unto him, why callest thou me good? There is none good but one, that is God. But if thou wilt enter into life, keep the commandments.
If you don't want to die, you must do what?
Keep the commandments.
If you don't want to burn forever, you have to do what?
Keep the commandments.
If you want Christ to save you when he returns, you have to do what?
Keep the commandments.
You got to keep God's commandments.
That's right.
That's what you got to do. That's your only option. Right? So guess what that means you need to do? Take your head off. Take your head off. All praise to the Most High. We ain't even got to go to it. Just take that off, because when we bring it out this word, you don't want to have your head covered dishonoring Christ, right?
That's
right. So, tell me, what's a good breakfast sound like for you? A good breakfast. Hold on, say that in the mic real quick.
Bacon, egg, and cheese.
Bacon, egg, cheese, biscuit. Bro, you like them from Burger King, McDonald's, stuff like that? You like those breakfast sandwiches, right? Give me that.
Yes, sir.
Give me that. Hey, guess what? You know why you like that? Because in slavery, they told black people, hey, here goes some pig, eat that.
Right.
We're going to be eating the ox.
Right.
We're going to be eating all that. And we even let you get the tail.
Bring it out.
We're going to eat the rest of the ox, though. We're going to eat the lamb. Right. We're going to eat the deer. We're going to eat all this. And you going to eat pork butt.
Right.
You going to eat chitlins.
Right.
Now, I seen a video on Facebook. They still had the booty hole on the plate. Why? Because that's what they taught us to eat.
Bring it out.
That's called slave food. And that's why we still like it today. Read that.
The book of Leviticus, chapter 11, verse 7. And the swine.
What swine? Yes, read.
Though he divide the hoof and be cloven footed, yet he cheweth not the cud. He is unclean to you.
He is what?
He is unclean to you.
Tell me, would you ever go outside and just start eating dirt off the ground? Why? Because it's dirty, right?
Right.
Would you just go put people's shoes in your mouth? Would you eat boo-boo? These are the things that pigs are doing.
That's right.
So when you eat them, that's what you're eating.
Right.
Essentially, right? God said that's not clean. You're not going to put no dirty diaper in your mouth.
Bring it out.
Right. So why are you putting pork in your mouth? It don't need to be no pork on your fork going forward. Because God said that's unclean. Right. Finish that out.
Of their flesh shall ye not eat.
Shall ye what?
Shall ye not eat.
What does shall ye not mean? We have to make sure he understands this. Shall ye not? What does that mean? That means don't do it.
Right. Bring it out.
That means don't do it.
Right.
So why in the church, pastor eating pork chops right after Sunday service?
Right. Man.
Why is that? Because they don't teach the commandments of God. They teach for hire.
That's right.
Tell me, how many times the plate done been passed to you in your life? It's innumerable. It's innumerable. They taught you to do that. And yet a plate. Oh yeah, you gotta pass the plate.
Right.
They make you feel bad. And they make you feel like you robbing God. Well, a man robbed God. Well, a man robbed God. Meanwhile, your money paying off your preacher Cadillac.
Bring it out.
You paying off his beans. He cleaned the mud, his hair slicked back. He like the preacher, the cleanest person in the church.
Right.
Why? Because you paying for everything. He's funded by you.
Right.
That's what you're doing. Where you at? Let's sit on that.
Yeah, let's sit on
all that. Right, so we got that out the way. Mm. But maybe that's not all my brother like to eat. Tell me, you ever been to Red Lobster? What you like to order from there?
Chicken Alfredo.
Chicken Alfredo, and what else? There's something else they put in the Alfredo that probably make it five for you. What's that? Nah, like it's another type of Alfredo with a different meat in it. Shrimp Alfredo, you like that? He said, yeah, they go crazy, right? Go crazy. Read what you got.
The book of Leviticus, chapter 11, verse 10, verse 9. These shall ye eat of all that are in the waters.
So God, he made water for a reason. He put animals in it.
Right.
Let's see if he put all of them in there for the same reason. Read.
Whatsoever had fins and scales.
Tell me, shrimp, do they got fins? They swim with fins? Obviously not, right? They got scales on the side of their body like regular fishes? So they don't. Read.
Whatsoever had fins and scales in the waters, in the seas, and in the rivers, them shall ye eat.
Them shall ye eat. So God, you know it's millions of fishes in the sea. That's why they say a plenty of fish in the sea.
Right.
You thought they was talking about your girlfriend, huh?
Right.
No, God made plenty of fishes for us to eat. You understand? It's fishes that your oppressor can't even discover.
Right.
You understand? That's how many God made. Read.
And all that have not fins and scales in the sea.
But some of them don't have fins and scales. Read.
And in the rivers,
uh-huh.
Of all that move in the waters,
uh-huh.
And of any living thing which is in the waters,
uh-huh.
They shall be an abomination unto you.
Hey, what?
An abomination unto you.
An abomination is abomination, a good thing. So if something is an abomination to you, are you going to eat it? No, it's an abomination to you. Give me that, an abomination. Read that.
The book of Sirach, chapter 15, verse 13. The Lord hated all abominations.
God does what?
The Lord hated all abominations.
So if God hates something, should you love it?
Mm.
Probably not. Probably not, right? Finish that. Finish that.
Uh-huh.
The Lord hated all abominations. And they that fear God, love it not.
There you go right there. If you fear God, you're not going to be eating shrimp Alfredo. You're not going to be eating crab legs. You break them apart and you take the little stuff out.
Right.
You ever notice if something, you're supposed to be eating something, you shouldn't have to do that much to eat it.
Take it out.
You ever notice with shrimp, they be having a little stuff coming out the butt.
Right.
You got the fact that you have to look around that to eat it should tell you that you're not supposed to be eating that. You cracking them legs, you trying to get the insides out of them. You never think like, this is nasty.
Right.
You might as well go eat a spider. You going to do that?
Right.
Tell me, would you ever, have water bugs at your house? Did you ever say, hey mama, don't kill it, I'm finna eat that. I can eat that for later, I put that in my Alfredo.
Bring it out.
You never said that. Why? Because that's nasty. It's the same thing with shrimp, bro. Shrimp are the roaches of the sea.
That's right.
Tell me, do you know what shrimp was made for? Tell me, is there anybody on earth that can go out and clean the ocean every day? No, the ocean is too big.
Right.
So God, being a God that knows everything, what you think he did? He created a fish to do that. He created an animal in the water to do that.
That's right.
And guess what? That's your catfish.
Mm.
That's your shrimp. That's your lobster. That's why those fishes don't have scales and fins.
Mm.
God created them for something else. He didn't create them for, you know, the same purposes as those other fishes.
Right.
God made them the filter of the sea, the filter of the oceans.
See.
So you going out and you eating them, who gonna clean the ocean? You gonna go clean it? So maybe you should stop messing with God's divine purpose.
Right.
God said, don't mess with those fishes. You're not supposed to eat them. So guess you're probably going to stop eating that after today, right? Finish that out. Right. Of their flesh shall ye not what?
Of their flesh shall ye not eat.
Uh-huh. God, no, it says, but ye, there you go. Yeah, so we're going to read Leviticus chapter 11 and verse 11 again for you, all right? Read that.
Leviticus chapter 11, verse 11. They shall be even an abomination unto you.
Uh-huh.
Ye shall not eat of their flesh.
You shall not what?
Ye shall not eat of their flesh.
God said don't eat of their flesh.
Right.
What is their flesh? It's their skin. It's the body of that animal. God said don't eat it.
Right.
So now you know not to eat shrimp, pork, crab, lobster, crawfish, none of that.
Teach.
Right? So you going to still do that after today? My man. That's one thing, knocked out. Just like that. Put your face mask down real quick. Like, let me see something real quick. Okay. Your beard probably don't grow, huh? You don't think so? Not a lot. But when it do grow, do you ever just shave it off real quick because you don't want it to look weird? You do that? Read that.
Bring it out.
The book of Leviticus, chapter 21, verse 5. They shall not make baldness upon their head.
So God said you can't make baldness upon your head. So when you get your sides cut, you can't get no designs.
Right.
You can't get no Allen Iverson and logo, the Nike sign. You know, our people are crazy. You gotta specify these things. So no Dragon Ball Z.
Right.
No Naruto, none of that. Right? God said don't do that. We learned that from the Egyptians.
Teach.
Right.
neither shall they shave off the corners of their beard.
So you can't shave off your beard whether it's growing patchy or not. So if your beard only growing this, your beard growing a circle on the side of your face, you can't shave it.
Right.
You can cut it down so it don't look as abrupt, but you can't shave it. You understand? God said we can't do that.
Right.
It's a shame for us to do that. Did you know that? It was a shame for an Israelite man in the Bible that to shave his beard.
Right.
You couldn't even come out. And King David said, nah, y'all gotta go. This is shameful. Y'all gotta go until y'all beards grow back.
Right.
You understand? So you gotta stop doing it. That's another lot. Yeah, finish that out.
Nor make any cuttings in their flesh.
Now, I'm gonna get a chest piece that say blessed.
Nor make any cuttings in their flesh.
I'm gonna get wings tatted on my back.
Nor make any cuttings in their flesh.
So I'm gonna get 501 tatted on my forearm.
Nor make any cuttings in their flesh.
Guess what? And God don't care if it's a Bible scripture or not.
Right.
He said no to tattoos.
Yeah.
We don't need tattoos. We already dark skinned.
Right.
What, you putting something on your body that people ain't gonna be able to see?
Right.
It's some people, it's like you dropped your flower, man. You're like, bro, as dark as you is, you feel the need to get a tattoo.
Right.
Really? Really? Tell me this, what tattoo parlor did Christ go to? When did Moses go get tatted up? Hey, tell me if I want a 6-point star on my right pec. God said don't do that.
Bring it out.
That's not our custom. Shaving our beards, not our custom. Barting our hair like Michael Jordan and Charles Barkley, not our custom.
That's right.
Guess what? Give me Leviticus 23.
Yes, sir.
What else is not our custom? Football games on Saturday. Football games at all ain't our custom. But definitely college football ain't. Saturdays and, you know, basketball games and AAU tournaments, that's not our custom, bro. Labor Day weekend grilling, that ain't our custom, bro.
Right.
Memorial Day ain't our custom, bro. We got our own feast days.
Right.
Guess what? Those holidays that America taught us, that's not our feast days.
Bring it out.
Cooking on Saturday, tell me, what day do black people come together?
Bring it out.
Sunday, okay, what day do people come together for barbecues? Saturdays. Are we supposed to be having barbecues on Saturday? That's usually what they family reunions
right.
on. Who we introducing. That's what we think. That's our custom. Family reunion on Saturday. God said what? Read Leviticus 23 and start at 2.
Yes, sir.
The book of Leviticus chapter 23 verse 2. Speak unto the children of Israel.
Children of who?
The children of Israel.
Who are you a child of? The children of what?
Israel.
You an Israelite. Right. They're talking about us.
Right.
The children of Israel. Just like, this is how you got to put it in perspective. What's your daddy name? Walter? It's a lot of Walters in our community. What's that about? God said, the children of Israel. So just like somebody say, hey, you Walter boy, you Walter son? You would know exactly who it's talking about, right?
Right?
Children of Israel, you know exactly who that's talking about. That's talking about you.
Bring it up.
Right? God said, this is a rule for the children of Israel. Finish that out, Rick.
And say unto them, concerning the feast of the Lord, ye which ye shall proclaim to be holy convocations, even these are my feasts.
These are my what?
My feasts.
These are God's what?
My feasts.
These are God's feasts. God got holidays that we can partake with him in. God said, you know what? I got a day that I like to kick it on.
Right.
So I want y'all to kick it with me.
Right.
Y'all my people. Just like the Saturday is my rest day, I want y'all resting with me.
Right.
Right? Because y'all my people and I love y'all. And whatever I get, y'all get.
That's
whatever
right.
is for me, is for y'all. Y'all are a reflection of me.
That's
y'all
right.
are my name in the earth. So guess what? When people see the Israelites, why they not spending no money on Saturdays?
Bring
because God said that's the day of rest.
That's right.
God said this is his feast. He ain't talking about the July 4th.
Right.
That ain't God's feast. He ain't talking about what some other feast days. Christmas, that ain't God's feast. Thanksgiving, that ain't God's feast. Just because you want beans, greens, tomatoes, damn chicken, you name it. God said don't cook on his feast.
Right.
Well, this feast, the Sabbath day. Now, we know we got other feast days that's made for cooking.
Right.
We specify. But the Sabbath day ain't made for that.
Right.
So leave all that alone. You understand that? All people get simple. Well, I can't eat. You can eat on the Sabbath day. You can eat a sandwich. You can eat a salad.
Right.
Cereal. Yeah, guess what? I already ate. You know
right.
what I'm saying? So if you don't eat, it's because you fasted. You understand? It was the Day of Atonement. That's the only reason you shouldn't be eating.
Right.
So God said this is his feast. God said we have to come together for that thing. Read.
6 days shall work be done.
Look, he eating right now.
Right.
6 days shall work be done. You got a job, bro? Where you work at? All praise to the Most High. God said, you can work there 6 days out of the week. You good, go make your money, because guess what? You got a family to feed.
That's right.
You got to feed yourself. God said, that's all right with me. Because guess what? I worked for 6 days too. God did that. He said, you can do it. But what did he say to do after that though, Rick?
But the seventh day.
The seventh day. When does that begin? Friday at sundown. That sun go down on Friday, it's a new day. I know you've been taught that the day start when? At midnight, right? You can look at the clock and then it go 11:59, 12, new day. That don't make no sense because it looked the same outside as it did at 11:59.
Right.
For all you know, if you ain't got a clock, you don't even know what day it is. Guess what? Back in the day, we didn't have clocks. Though your oppressor gave you a clock and said it's 12 now.
Right.
It's 7 now. Back in the day, we understood what hour it was. You know, and we had sundials. We knew what day it was and we knew what time it was based on the sun and the moon.
That's right.
That's how we knew. Before the white man changed time and laws, he didn't have this confusion. So the seventh day begins on Friday night.
Right.
Come on.
But the seventh day is the Sabbath of rest.
So that's when the Sabbath begins. The Sabbath of rest. Meaning this day is all about rest. So no working. Tell Shotgun then I can't work on Saturdays no more.
That's right.
I ain't making no damn pizza on Friday night.
Right.
To hell with your pepperonis.
Right.
To hell with your breadsticks. It's the seventh day.
That's
and
I'ma right.
keep it holy because God said so.
Bring
Come
on.
Ye shall do no work therein.
You shall do no work therein. So no cutting the grass on Saturday.
Bring it on.
You understand? God said this is the day of rest. Where you need to be on Saturday? You still something? Read.
And holy convocation.
Where you at? What verse you at?
Verse 3.
Read.
6 days shall work be done, but the seventh day is the Sabbath of rest. And holy convocation.
Guess what we supposed to be doing on Saturdays or what?
And holy convocation.
Tell me, is a holy convocation coming together for Greek fraternities, screaming who you with?
Bring it out.
Who you with? Get crunk, who you with? You gonna congregate with the noobs? Right. All praise to the Most High. Hey, God said it's a holy convocation. It's a holy convocation, so where you need to be on Saturday? With like-minded believers, the Israelites. You need to come join us today, bro. Our website, our address is on that flyer. You want to make God happy, right? You want to do the things pleasing to God? Start keeping his commandments.
That's right.
Today is the Sabbath day. This is your chance to make a decision.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission. Minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road. Purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.